Jake Connor announced his arrival on the international stage as England emerged victorious in their ambitious Denver experiment. Connor scored one try and made two others to help Wayne Bennett's side recover from an early 12-0 deficit to record an impressive 36-18 win. Bennett also had outstanding performances from fellow debutant Tommy Makinson and back rower Elliot Whitehead, who finished with two tries and an assist. Ryan Hall and John Bateman were England's other scorers, with Dylan Selesniak touching down twice and Izan Marsters once for the Kiwis, who were playing for the first time under new coach Michael Maguire. Here's five talking points from the game. England's players and officials publicly pushed hard for this game to take place amid significant opposition from NRL clubs, which dominated the build-up. In the end, a crowd of 19,320 came to Denver Broncos Mile High Stadium to witness a stirring test match between two passionate countries, and lessons will undoubtedly have been learned. The plan is for two more of these games to go to America in 2019 and 2020, and the sooner details are confirmed for those, the quicker organizers can get on with making the next event more successful. A near 20,000 in foreign fields should not be sniffed at, and administrators hope that this is the first major footprint in a wider plan to take the sport across the USA in coming years. A planned club in New York is set to join the ambitious Toronto Wolfpack in joining the English competitions, so the sport's reach across the Atlantic is growing. And those players that stood up for the right to play in Denver this time could yet find themselves being key men in history if Rugby League eventually achieves its objectives in America. Hull FC utility Connor has been one of the stars of the Super League campaign season, particularly after switching to halfback in the absence of the injured Mark Snead. That earned his first call-up to the national side and many felt he should have started instead of being named as substitute. But when Connor got his opportunity as a first-half replacement for Johnny Lomax, he took it with both hands. The skillful 23-year-old created first-half tries for Ryan Hall and Elliot Whitehead that dragged his side back into the game after they trailed 12-0. Then in the second half he split the Kiwi defense and dummied past fullback Dylan Selesniak for a stunning solo score. As international debuts go, they don't come much better, although Tommy Makinson pushed him close with his own sparkling bow at this level. An apparent second-half shoulder injury was the only real negative for Connor, but he will now expect to feature in the three-match test series against the Kiwis in the autumn. When England's NRL players were publicly standing up for the right to stage this game, Sam Burgess was at the front of the queue. And his passion for International Rugby League was just as clear to see on the pitch as he tore into New Zealand from the off. Whenever there was any confrontation between the two sets of players, Burgess was inevitably in the mix. He might not have had the captain's armband on he wore in the World Cup final in the absence of the injured Sean O'Loughlin, but the South Sydney talisman is undoubtedly a leader for his country. The experienced New Zealand hooker has long been a pantomime villain opponent for England supporters. Back in 2011, Luke publicly admitted that he tried to break the leg of Ranji Chase in the test match between the countries. He was involved in the dark arts again when John Bateman objected to him standing on his hand in the 48th minute, although the England man initially picked out the wrong opponent. Luke also booted kickoffs out on the full three times in the high-altitude conditions. But the 31-year-old also made a brilliant break for Dylan Selesniak's first half try and kicked a superb 40-20 to remind everyone what a talented player he is as well. James Graham became the first player to have a golden lion embroidered on his shirt as a mark of his 40th England cap. The non-stop prop has been the cornerstone of his country's pack for over a decade now. But a late chance to mark the occasion with an unheard-of conversion was missed when he pushed his kick wide following John Bateman's last-minute try. Regular kicker Gareth Widdop will be confident of holding on to the job for the autumn test series with the Kiwis.